Colonel Lalit Agnihotri has dialed in. How can we help you, Colonel?
Yeah, I've got a query which is unique. You see, firstly, I must compliment you for having this kind of programs. It is very knowledgeable programs.
Thank you very much.
My question is, because generally you have been answering questions where the possession is being delayed, how to go about it. My case is the reverse case. The reverse case is, I've already got a flat which is been offered for possession by the Tatas. Now, the question is...
Colonel Agnihotri, if your TV is on, you'll need to mute it because it's causing a lot of disturbance.
No, I have already muted it. Don't worry about it.
Okay.
So, in my case, the builder Tata is forcing me to have to register my flat before possession. I paid them all the dues. They say, unless you register the flat in your name, then only we'll hand over the possession. So I just want to know, what is the legal position on this? That is the first question.
Okay.
So can he withhold possession after receiving all dues and forcing me to register the flat? That is my first question.
Okay. So essentially, very quickly, Anshuman, we are running out of time here, so we'll need to do it fast. Can they withhold possession if he's not registered the agreement?
See, it's an obligation of the builder to execute the agreement with the flat purchasers and to register the same. Now, they are ready and willing. It appears that you are not ready and willing for that. So therefore, this issue has come up before you. If you don't have any specific reasons, my question to you is, why aren't you doing the same? Because that discharges the developer of his obligation. Because if this is a standard every flat purchaser will take, then the builder can really have a situation subsequently at the time of handing over of possession and charge to the society. So my suggestion is that you should go ahead and do that. So far as legal position is concerned, it is a contractual thing. You may have to check up your agreement at the same time. But nevertheless, that if he intends to discharge his obligation, he would be in a position to hold you on so far as you are not able to comply with your obligation. Otherwise, you may have to give him a writing stating that you will not hold him any responsible. Based on that, you can take it up.
Right. Ideally, Colonel Agnihotri, you need to register that agreement within 8 months of, executing that agreement. Also, before you need to do that by the time you've paid over 20% of the consideration, that is the cost of the flat. Go on. What is your next question? Okay, Colonel Agnihotri has, I think we've lost him. However, what is essential for home buyers to know, Anshuman, correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe registration is one proof that you have, that you actually own the flat, right? That is a legal document which can be shown in court if there is a problem tomorrow, right?
What happens is, registration is a requirement under the Registration Act. Any transaction of an immovable property is governed under the sections 17 and 18. So 17 regarding all the documents which have to be mandatorily registered. Over a period of time, the courts have held that transactions of flat purchase have to be mandatorily registered. So therefore, there is no substitute for that. Now, by not registering it, the ability of the flat purchaser to approach the court is curtailed, and subsequently the document to be held in evidence and to be used for the purpose of proving specific performance or otherwise will be in a jeopardy. So therefore, it is always preferred and advisable to have the document stamped and fully registered.